That's not me. That's celebrated international singing star Duncan from Blues. And that's my ex-girlfriend, Lindsay, who dumped me for him.
My name's Rob Black, and this is how it should be.
Look, Lindsay, I'm sorry, it's over.
But why, Duncan from Blue?
Isn't it obvious?
Because of all the weight I've put on, isn't it?
No, darling. Whilst absolutely repulsive to look at and skin-crawling to the touch, it's not that.
Then why, Duncan from Blue? Why?
I've realised that I'm a massive gay.
So, my ex-girlfriend's got fat, the bloke she dumped me for has got gay, and my life has been nothing short of brilliant since she gave me the boot.
Why did I ever leave you?
Yeah, that's how it should be. It's not how it is, though. She's not fat, he's not gay, they're blissfully happy, and compared to Duncan's, my life sucks cock. Examples? Duncan's house has been on telly.
Yo, what's up? Welcome to my pad, everyone. Now, whoa, you're not going in there, because that's my bedroom, and that's already seen far too much action today. But come through this way to my kitchen. As you can see, it doesn't look like it's ever been used. That's because it hasn't been used. Well, not for cooking, anyway. Now, over here is the best bit about my yard. This is my view. I can tell you something now. This is a great place to make love first thing in the morning.
And my house has been on telly.
Last night's sewage pipe explosion continues to cause havoc for West London residents, with no end in sight yet for those affected.
Duncan works in the record industry. And so do I. Yep, every day of my working life is spent making shitty love song compilations. And as an extra special bonus, there's always one on there by the bloke who's nobbing my ex-girlfriend. No, wait. The extra, extra special bonus is that even the people who like me think he's better than I am.
For example, my sister, Rebecca. It's just not fair. I mean, what does this shit mean? You're just not sensitive to my emotional needs like Duncan is. Not sensitive? Who was there for after her father died? Me, that's who, not Duncan from Blue.
You burst out laughing when she told you.
Rebecca, Lindsay's dad was struck in the face on a roller coaster by a low-flying goose.
Your girlfriend's dad's death is never a laughing matter, Robert. And that is why she's with Duncan from Blue.
My brother, Rich.
That's it! Take his legs, you Nancy boy!
I just don't get it. Why him? Why Duncan from Blue?
Girls. Come on. Right. Now. Who fancies him? Now, who fancies him?
Sorry, mate.
Even my best mate, Paul, thinks Duncan from Blues better than me.
All I'm saying is, he's an all right bloke. Whenever I've met him, he's always bought me a beer. You never do.
That's because you're a recovering alcoholic.
Just saying what I see. Chin up a touch, love.
Now, they're getting married.
The bastards.
This is lovely. It's a really heavy card. And it's embossed. This is so expensive.
Yeah, all right, Laura, it's bad enough as it is.
Oh, my God, you don't want her back, do you?
Fuck no. What annoys me is that people will assume I'm upset about the wedding, whereas what actually upsets me is that of the two blokes in that room who have seen Lindsay's fanny, I'm the least impressive.
But I'll go then.
That's admitting defeat.
No, I've thought of a plan. So, I'm
single, homeless, sleeping on my sister's couch, and everything I own smells of shit. Uh-huh. But the invitation says plus one. So while I'm never going to be as impressive as Duncan from Blue, I'll bring a date along who is. I'll be fighting fire with fire. Sexy fire.
So you're going to the wedding with the express intention of outshining the bride and groom? Robert, that's a demented idea. It's not a competition.
Yes, it fucking is. It's a matter of pride, ain't that right, bruv?
Still can't work out how to send a text message on this thing.
Oh, for God's sake. Yeah.
So, who are you going to take? What about our Polly bird we met at our party?
She's stunning.
She's also a stunning drunk. No, I need a date who'll make people believe that I am the greatest and most successful man that has ever lived, just by sheer proximity.
Are you planning on taking Jesus?
No. You want to take someone like this?
Rob!
Oh, God, we missed you. Gemma, this is Lindsay's mum, Barbara, and her uncle, Phil. Phil and Barbara, this is
Gemma Atkinson, star of Hollyoaks. Hollyoaks Let Loose, Hollyoaks in the City, the face of the British Grand Prix, and of course, who can forget your fourth place performance in Soap Star Superstar?
Oh, Phil, don't embarrass the poor girl. You'll be bringing up the fact she was voted 23rd sexiest woman in the world by FHM next.
Yeah.
Unlike our Lindsay, I might add.
Oh, Lindsay's a beautiful girl.
No, no, she's not. I mean, she'll do. But compared to you, she's fucking hideous, isn't she, Phil?
She is, yeah. God, I wish I'd given you away today.
Oh, excuse me. Hello?
Rob, she's...
Hiya. Oh, that's great news. Thanks. Bye. That was FHM on the phone. I've only been voted number 17 this year.
Oh. That's terrific.
Okay, one question. How the hell do you think he is ever going to get Gemma Atkinson to be his date, you deluded buffoon?
You're on your own there, bruv.
And even if he did manage to pull Gemma Atkinson and take her back to his place is either a duvet on my couch or a flat full of shit. So unless Hollyoaks do a sexy late-night spin-off series called Hollyoaks in a Flat Full of Shit, you are never going to meet. And even if by some miracle you do, she's still got to overcome the flat full of shit.
Hi, everybody. How's it going?
Right, we're off down the pub.
See you later. Your sister's all right.
What do you mean?
She's nice. She's good looking. Sexy in there.
You saying you fancy my sister?
She smells all sort of warm, milky.
She's my sister. Don't think of her like that.
Sorry. I think of every woman I've ever met like that. Except my nan, obviously.
What about your mum?
I've seen some photos of her from the 70s. She was fit.
Lucky. But she's still your mum.
Not in 75, she wasn't. I wasn't born for another year. See, I reckon if I built a time machine, went back in time, 74 maybe, I could shake my mum. Be my own dad, and technically it wouldn't be a bad thing.
Technically?
Yeah, because it wouldn't even exist.
But she's still your mum.
Not in 74, she wasn't.
No, Paul, she's your mum, full stop. You're talking about shagging your own mother.
No, I'm talking about shagging your sister. You got me onto shagging my mum.
Well, stop talking about shagging my sister.
I'm just saying she's a good-looking one.
Well, just don't. It's freaking me out.
Evening, benders. Come on. This is Kerry. Kerry, this is my brother Rob, and this is mate Paul.
Do it.
Hiya. Have you got money for a drink?
Yeah, of course. So, you want to make a splash when you enter this wedding, right?
Yes.
So what I was thinking was, take a leaf out of my book, rock up there with an 18-year-old girl on your arm.
That's your solution to fucking everything. Just been dumped, get an 18-year-old girlfriend. Job getting you down, get an 18-year-old girlfriend. House buried under 2 feet of liquid shit, you've yet to offer this up, but I imagine your solution would be get an 18-year-old girlfriend.
How'd you get away with it anyway? You're a teacher?
Yeah, I teach 11 to 16-year-olds. The girls I go out with are 18+. That's street legal. So anyway, I was thinking, Kerry and her mates from college are having a party Thursday night. Why don't you come? There should be loads of teenage poon knocking about.
Jesus. You know, I don't want to while away my Thursday evening playing spin the fucking bottle with the cast of Grange Hill, so thanks, Rich, but I'll pass on that one. Right, we'll be off, I think.
Well, if you change your mind, party, Thursday.
Yeah, it'll be well cool. Darren's brother's getting us some weed.
Bro, have you left our rise by blue off again?
I'm not giving that ice-skating bastard any more royalty checks to spend on marrying my ex-girlfriend.
Anyway, have you found a supermodel to shag yet?
Uh-huh. Well, there you are, you see.
What?
You see, what you singly fail to grasp is I don't want to shag this hypothetical woman. I just want to be her friend.
Bollocks.
No, serious. I need a 10. And at best, I'm a 7.
7.
6.5. Okay, 5.
What about my flatmate, Nikki?
Do you live in the Playboy Mansion?
No.
What about your flatmate, then?
Well, she's a model, that's what. And she's single at the minute, so she could do with a nice night out, no strings attached. Everyone's a winner.
Great. That'd be good. Thanks, Laura. Can you bring in a picture first? I don't want to be funny, but there are models and then there are models, you know what I mean?
I can do better than a picture. That's her.
Are you out there looking for that
pal? Is this a fucking joke?
Just can't
go wide. Go wide, go wide. Go wide, go wide, go wide, go
wide. Yes. Dazzling, sparkly, elegant and sexy.
And on a personal note to you, Nikki, I just want to say that when I saw you modelling that wedding ring a few months ago, I thought, that's the ring I want to marry my wife with. Sadly, Lindsay's fingers are a lot fatter than yours, but the ring still looks fantastic. So here's to Nikki and her much thinner fingers.
The thinner fingers! Thinner fingers!
I really believe this could be the solution for you.
I love you.
Serious. One thing I've gained from my job is the uncanny ability to guess a woman's favourite song just by looking at her.
Okay. We'll do it now then. In the restaurant.
Okay. Right, I'll give you an advance warning. 97.4% of all women's favourite songs is Angels by Robbie Williams. So, did make this even slightly challenging. I have to find the 2.6% who don't like it. Ah. Okay, it's a precise mathematical formula here. From Angels on, it's a 50-50 split between... Excuse me, my friend and I are playing a game. Is your favourite song Brown Eyed Girl by Van Morrison?
Oh, my God. How did you know that?
Thank you very much.
How did you know that? Are you a mind reader?
She's got brown eyes. It's not rocket science.
Yeah, but still, you're good.
I don't know.
Okay, so what's my favourite song?
Well, that'll have to wait until next time. Yeah, can we get the bill now, please?
Thanks for tonight. I've had a really nice time. God, I seem to meet so many mentals. It's really nice to meet someone normal.
I wouldn't be so sure of that.
Do you want to come back to mine for a drink?
I'd love to, but... no, I can't. I've got to be in work. Early, we're very busy. Another time, definitely.
What about tomorrow? I could come to yours. Is this poo?
Or I could come to yours instead and cook you something.
Excellent. Okay, well, I'll give you my number and we can sort it out tomorrow.
Great.
Oh, give it here. See? And you can be completely perfect. You love Nikki, you wanna kiss her sexy face and make her your special lady.
Mm-hmm. For the last time, no, I do not.
Oh, why the hell not? She's lovely. Are you mental?
If by mental you mean genius, then yes, I am.
She likes me because I'm not trying to screw her. If I had tried to screw her, she wouldn't like me. Ergo, I am achieving what I set out to achieve, i.e. make a nice female friend who's so incredibly beautiful people will assume I own a yacht.
Okay, look, I know you're not going to try an omelette, but...
But what?
What if she wants you to? What if she fancies you?
Laura, she'd never fancy me. Next to her, I'm like something from Lord of the Rings. Besides, if sex comes into it, it'll end badly. Look, you're not going to be there tonight, are you? Watching.
Rob, I have no idea what's going on with you and my flatmate, but I certainly don't want to see it. Just...
Just what?
Whatever happens, don't fuck it up.
The doctor is in. Spaghetti Diavolo, my signature dish, containing one vital ingredient.
Chilies.
Red Hot Chili Peppers, to be precise, who sang the song Under the Bridge, which, unless my powers are failing me, is, yes, coming through loud and clear, your favourite song.
Oh, God, it's like magic. Or it's like you asked my flatmate earlier today at work.
Ah.
I'm sure you would have got there yourself eventually. I'll leave you to do your thing.
She's just a friend. She's just a friend. I must be out of my fucking mind. What? I'm busy.
All right, bruv. First party.
They've got to come down and bail me out.
Why?
Because it's full of puffs.
I'm the only straight bloke here. One of them might try and bum me.
Yeah, just to be clear, are these men actually kissing or are they just drinking rosé?
Just come down here, you'll be doing me a favour.
Go away.
Oh, come on, you
Pardon me, gorgeous, but might sir use la toilette?
Yeah, it's upstairs on the right.
You've got it all wrong.
All wrong? You were wanking into my toothbrush mug.
I wasn't wanking. I've just rubbed chili into my cock.
You're an absolute fucking sex case.
I'm not. I didn't even want you to fancy me. I just wanted to be friends. It's all about the wedding.
You want to get married? Are you fucking mental? I've only met you twice. I'm going to count to 10 and then I'm calling the police. 1, 2, 3.
Nikki, please. You've got it all wrong.
Get out! Bye.
Have you pissed yourself?
Paul, my entire life has just pissed itself. What are you doing here anyway?
I just came to see how the big date went.
So how was it then? You seeing her again?
Not without a lawyer present.
Didn't it go well?
Not really. I think it was the point she walked in on me dipping my penis in her toothbrush mug that did it. Either that or she's not a big fan of pasta.
You're kidding.
I wish I was.
Who doesn't like pasta?
No, the first bit was the problem.
That actually happened?
Oh, yes.
He's not a pervert. He probably did accidentally get chili on his cock, then probably did accidentally not find anything other than the toothbrush mug to dip it in. And he doesn't want to marry you. That's just... that's a different story. But there will be an explanation for all this. It'll be a fucked up explanation, but there will be one, okay?
Okay.
Speak to him tomorrow. It'll be fine. I'll make us a nice cup of tea.
God, what was your last mobile? Two paper cups and a piece of string? Give it to me.
No. I have to master this myself. Hang on. Let's see. Message. Oh, God, it's from Nikki. Oh, wow. It's possible you're not a pervert. Let's speak tomorrow. Fucking... yes! Thank you, God!
My brother. Possibly not a pervert. I'm so proud.
Ah. Rich. Please save me. The gays keep looking at me.
He is such a knob, your brother.
Text him back and tell him he's going to get bum raped, silly bastard.
You are going to get bum raped.
See? I'm possibly not a pervert. It always works out in the end. The date was just, well, a catastrophic balls up. But the plan's still good.
Shall I tell you about my life? They say I'm a man of the world. I've flown across every time.
There. Hey. Morning.
I've seen lots of pretty.
With just a little top rank grovelling, I'll be walking into Lindsay's wedding with the most beautiful woman in the world.
The fact that so many of our friends could be here today means so very much to us. Especially you, Rob, who, as we all know, was right. Lindsay's father's death was very funny. So here's to Rob, everyone.
That's
him.
What?
You're gonna get bum raped.
Bum raped.
Oh, fuck.
Can we have a word, please, sir?
It's a joke, it's a misunderstanding. It was for my brother.
Desi Gallagher and Patrick McDonnell are the Egits in next week's Comedy Showcase, same time, 10:30. See more about that in a sec. Hugh Grant is splashing his Mickey Blue Eyes our direction Sunday night at 9. Tonight, though, Father Ted is like a rabbit caught in the headlights. Hop to it, next on 4.